Good evening, everyone. Today, I'd like to tell you about education and human development. It seems to me that human development is closely related with good education. And education is the panacea of all social, economic, and political ailments. So that is why education is the most important thing on which all the decision makers, all the policy makers, and all the academicians should put most emphasis. I, being an advocate, I being a headmaster of a school, always try to give emphasis on value education, moral education, discipline education among my students. And I believe that without good education, without proper education, without scientific education, no society can thrive, no society actually can sustain. It seems to me, you see, that, if you say that, what is human development? To me, very simply, from my common sense, I say, human means people, and develop means transition from one's bad position to better position. Bad position to better position. That is called transition. That is called development. And human development means the development or transition or transformation of one person's bad situation to better situation, right? So it might be a very simplistic analysis of the terminology. So therefore, it is imperative to understand the concept deeply from the definition of the United Nations. So the Human Development Report 2019 considers that human development means expanding the substantive freedoms to do things that people value and have a reason to value. You see, different people have defined differently about human development. I told you about my perception. Human development means development of human beings from his or her or their bad position to better position, right? Further, it is indicated that human development is not defined merely by the choices that people make. It is also defined by the freedom that a person has in choosing from the set of feasible functionings, which is referred to as the person's capability. Now, Amartya Sen and others are giving emphasis or putting emphasis on skill development or capacity development. So, empowerment or development is related nowadays with capacities of people, with skills of people. Nowadays, you may have attained master degree in any subject, but unless and until you achieve special skills, you cannot claim that you are very worthy and you are very up to date and you are very fit for the job market of the 21st century. So in the 21st century, mere attaining a college and university degrees is not all. Rather, one will have to learn or one will have to achieve some special skill that might be computer literacy, that might be programming, that might be accountancy, that might be language skills, that might be robotic engineering, that might be space technology, that might be nanotechnology, that might be mathematics, and particularly STEM. In a word, we can tell STEM. We have to give emphasis on STEM, means science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So this is my perception. And I will tell my students put emphasis on STEM, right? So, and if you say then education, what is education? So education also has a different meaning to different people, right? Education is a process actually that a person learns throughout his life. Simply, you can say. So it is a condition and it is a continuous process indeed. In the previous century, the concept was meant to teach basic things of life and society. Before that, India had a Gurukul system of education, but now in the 21st century, the concept of education has been changed dramatically. Now we are talking about quality education, skill education, management education, spiritual education, technical education, basic education, vocational education, etc. Right? So all these concepts encompass the concept of human development. Now it is a well-established fact that there is a correlation between quality education and human development. For the holistic development of a country, it requires quality education. Without quality education, no family, no society, no state, no country can develop, prosper, and grow and become happy, peaceful, prosperous. It is impossible. So knowledge, proper knowledge, proper education, scientific education is the core of human development. According to the United Nations, quality education, I would like to say, quote, a quality education is the foundation of sustainable development and therefore of the sustainable development goals. As a policy intervention, education is a force multiplier which enables self-reliance, boosts economic growth by enhancing skills, and improves people's lives by opening up opportunities for better livelihood, unquote. So it is the definition of quality education given by the United Nations. And actually, this is goal number, SDG number 4, right? So therefore, we find that human development and education are closely related. The Human Development Report 2019 considers that human development means expanding the substantive freedoms to do things that people value and have a reason to value, right? So, further it is indicated in the HDR 2019 that, quote, human development is not defined merely by the choices that people actually make. It is also defined by the freedom that a person has in choosing from the set of feasible functionings, which is referred to as the person's capability. So 21st century is the century of skills, the country, the family, the society, which creates more capable persons, more skilled persons. That society, that family, that country only develop and sustain in this 21st century. So this is a mantra of development, of growth. That is why the government of India has put so much emphasis on science and technology, innovation, manufacturing, space technology, defense technology, right? So these are the upcoming areas where we can we can give more emphasis, we can influence our students and younger generation to come in the field of science and technology and take this country ahead of others. If India wants to achieve $25 trillion economy, then India must give more emphasis on research and development, on freedom of universities and innovative ideas. Definitely, only I say that only restriction should be on national security and national dignity. Otherwise, give freedom to the universities and give target to make best papers, to make best researches, to make best academicians and make best researches on new things, on different things. India is doing excellently. Indian scholars and Indian research scholars are giving days and nights, and they are working very hard for the growth and development of this nation. And many people are engaged in actually development activities by their own skills and capabilities and their own areas, by studying hard, by working hard day and night. Once again, I appeal those who are still not engaged fully, are not giving their full efforts for the national growth and development, should come forward and join hands together with their friends, family members and colleagues to leave egos and put more time in academy, more education, skill development and ultimately national development, because my aim is only to become world's not only the largest democracy. India should be world's most economic power, most renowned or most developed or number one military power or most important spiritual country. India is still a spiritual country, but still I want that all the people people from all over the world should come here India to study more, to learn more, to attain their spirituality, to attain more spirituality and become happy and become prosperous. India is a land, India is a very pure land. So I welcome everybody from all over the world to come India and have the taste of hospitality and take the taste of the purity of mind of the people of this holy land. I welcome all of you to come India, maybe as a tourist, maybe as an investor, or maybe as a collaborator, or maybe as a spirituality seeker. So just come here in India and see the behavior, hospitality and big heart of Indian people. Right. Thank you. Thank you very much.